Good afternoon. Welcome to the commencement exercises for the graduating class of Green Run Collegiate, class of 2023. At this time, please rise and remain standing for the procession led by the school system administrators, board members, and the faculty of Green Run Collegiate. It is my pleasure to present to you the Green Run Collegiate class of 2023. Standing for the presentation of colors, followed by our national anthem. Gentlemen, please remove your caps.
Good afternoon, please be seated. My name is Mrs. Patricio, head of school, and I'm happy to welcome you all to the commencement exercises for Green Run Collegiate class of 2023. At this time, we would like to recognize our special guests. We ask that all guests remain standing until everyone has been acknowledged. Please hold your applause until the end. So at this time, I would like to recognize the Green Run Collegiate governing and Foundation Board members, Mr. Joe Burnsworth, Mr. Alex Exkew, Dr. Pete Baker, Mrs. Rebecca Bragg, Ms. Esther Pierre-Seuss, Mrs. Audrey Curtis, Dr. Wendy Ray Howard, and Mr. Mark Johnson. Next, please welcome the Virginia Beach City Public School Administration. Senior Executive Director of High Schools, Dr. Walter Brower, Chief of Schools Officer, Mr. Matthew Delaney, Chief of Staff, Dr. Donald Robertson Jr. I would also like to recognize Virginia Beach School Board members, Ms. Trinace Riggs, Chair, Ms. Beverly Anderson, Ms. Kathleen Brown, Ms. Jennifer Franklin, and Mrs. Kimberly Melnick. Please join me in a round of applause. Thank you. And Ms. Beverly Anderson. We'd also like to welcome you, our parents, guardians, family members, and friends here with us this afternoon to commemorate this special occasion. At this time, I would like to present to you our first graduate speaker, Mariah Kennedy.
It is truly a privilege to be here in front of you all, celebrating one of the major early milestones for the graduating class of 2023. Before continuing, I would like to first give thanks to the head of our school, Ms. Patricio, and our assistant principal, Ms. Waters, for giving me the opportunity to briefly speak before you all. To my friends and extended family, as well as the families and friends of graduates here this evening, we would all like to thank you for your ongoing assistance and love throughout this turbulent high school experience. I'm sure that the graduating class can remember that it wasn't long ago where we found our ninth grade selves aimlessly wandering through the hallways and being trampled in the constantly flooded library intersection. It wasn't long ago when we awkwardly stepped into our classes, only knowing a couple of people from middle school, and found it difficult to know where to sit or stand during one lunch, and wondering what the future would hold for us. It wasn't that long ago when we were introduced to teachers that left lasting impressions on us, such as Mr. Keith and Ms. Buckles, Madame Hyman, Ms. Matulis, and many others. It also wasn't that long ago where teachers such as Ms. Jones made it her mission to interact with us during the online period of our education. Post-pandemic, we all found ourselves magically studying for IAs and being swamped in loads of work that was starkly different from years before. We became accustomed to Dr. Green welcoming our extremely energetic teenage selves so early in the morning with the saying, "Good morning, my happy campers." We grew to understand Mr. Jackson's minutes of mindfulness, all while struggling to understand his unique grading style. We survived HLEs, orals, language exams, and reflective essays, all while playing sports, diving into extracurriculars, and complaining about the load of coursework on the side. We created bonds and formed relationships, as well as individual characteristics which continue to uniquely define all of us. For myself especially, I broke out of my introverted and reserved shell somewhat, and built relationships through sports, clubs, and classes, relationships that I can only accredit to this school. All of the lessons we've learned, the books we read, essays we wrote, nights spent cramming for the test in the upcoming day, specifically in Ms. Eichner's class, and the variety of delightful and dreadful experiences that we have had throughout our education has all led up to this day that, ironically, came so fast. And now, collectively, we find ourselves applying for colleges, military institutes, and future employment together. We find ourselves dressing up for prom and embracing our last year of high school together. We now find ourselves closing a long-awaited chapter of our lives and entering into an era of young adulthood together. I know that today will elicit different feelings for each of us. To some, today comes as a welcome relief or a huge sigh of satisfaction, while to others, it is accompanied with the feeling of nostalgia as we look back onto past memories and the relationships that have been forged along our high school years. Most of us are looking into the future with anticipation, excitement, and perhaps some apprehension. We are concerned about what to do with our lives, whether we attend college, join the armed forces, or begin a career instantaneously. However, the question that I would like to leave the audience, specifically my peers with, before we leave, is one that can be defined and molded by each and every one of us. For each graduate, understand that you are the curator of your destiny, the author to the chapters of your life, and the illustrator to your own story. So as we all reminisce on the past 4 years at Green Run Collegiate, whether it be the memories made, the good and the bad things you've experienced, the relationships built. Attempt to understand the direction that you would like to take your life, one step at a time. Truly ask yourself, how will you mold your future? Thank you.
And now I have the privilege of introducing this year's second graduate speaker, Luke Moore.
Ladies and gentlemen, esteemed faculty members, parents, guardians, and my fellow classmates of the graduating class of Greenland Collegiate, I stand before you today filled with immense pride and joy as we gather to celebrate this momentous occasion, the high school commencement of the remarkable class of 2023. Today marks the end of an incredible journey, one that has been marked by growth, resilience, and countless memories. Reflecting back on these, it is hard not to see the growth and change each and every one of us has experienced. For me, it is about a foot in height and the friendships that have changed my life. We have celebrated and overcome together. We even persevered through the pandemic, meeting challenges no one has ever dreamed of. We owe a debt of gratitude to the exceptional educators who have guided us through this transformative period of our lives. Our teachers here at GOC have gone above and beyond what is normally asked of a teacher, from staying for hours after school to make sure we were ready for our exams, to spending countless hours poring over our IAs and EEs to ensure the best score possible. Our teachers have sacrificed their personal lives in order for us to be successful. Not only have teachers helped us grow academically, but they have also helped us mentally. I truly believe that every single teacher here cares for us, not as students, but as people. No matter what problem I had, these teachers were always willing and able to help me. Every teacher at GOC has been committed to helping us grow as people just as much as helping us grow as students. Let us take a moment to express our heartfelt appreciation to the teachers, administrators, and support staffs who have dedicated themselves to our success. However, as we celebrate our achievements, we must acknowledge that the journey does not end here. In fact, this is just the beginning. We are on the cusp of a new chapter, a chapter that will test our mettle, push our limits, and present us with a myriad of opportunities. Graduates, as we step into the world, into this next chapter of our lives, it is important for us to remember our IB learner profile traits, which Ms. Patricio so adamantly spoke about. As we embark on this new chapter in our lives, we will surely face uncertainty and doubt. However, we must be risk takers and embrace this unknown, as it is within those uncharted territories that we will discover our true potential. Throughout these next steps, it is essential that we remain inquirers as we foster our curiosity and continue to learn throughout the rest of our careers. Most importantly, we must never forget to be caring. In a world that can sometimes be unkind and divided, we must be the beacon of compassion and understanding, to lift others up, empower those around us, and use our knowledge and skills to make a difference in the lives of others. We have the power to shape the future, to be agents of change, and to leave an indelible mark on the world. As we bid farewell to our beloved alma mater, let us take a moment to express our gratitude to our families and loved ones who have supported us unwaveringly throughout this incredible journey. They have been our pillars of strength, our cheerleaders, and our biggest advocates. Their love, sacrifices, and encouragement have propelled us forward, and for that, we are forever indebted. In conclusion, class of 2023, as we stand on the precipice of a new beginning, let us embrace the opportunities that await us with open hearts and open minds. Let us carry the lessons we have learned, the friendships we have forged, and the memories we have created as we venture forth into the world. May your future be filled with boundless possibilities, and may you leave an indelible legacy wherever life takes you. Thank you, and best of wishes for all that lies ahead. Congratulations.
Thank you so much, Mariah and Luke. At this time, we would like to present an award unique to Green Run Collegiate.
The Laureate Medallion is presented to two seniors nominated by their teachers. The recipients of these medals have consistently exemplified IB learner profile traits. This award is not necessarily for academic achievement. Rather, it recognizes students who have demonstrated excellence in service, compassion, inquiry, and leadership, thereby bringing honor and distinction to our school. The word laureate signifies great honor and distinction, and it is with great pleasure that I acknowledge one of our seniors. This extraordinary individual is positively positive, has an infectious smile that brightens the lives of those around her. Students at GRC take pride in embracing the process, and she has done this with her steadfast commitment to personal excellence, never shying away from a challenge and seeking out honest feedback as a catalyst for growth. For her selflessness, willingness to take on new responsibilities, and commitment to excellence, please join me in congratulating our first Laureate Medallion recipient, Alexis Lexi Taylor.
Congratulations.
The next student is a role model both on and off the basketball court. He is a dedicated, caring, and smart young man who consistently provides an example to his class and teammates. Over the past 4 years, he has grown from a quiet freshman to a leader at his school. He is principled and open-minded and encourages the people around him to strive to be the same. For his consistent display of the IB learner profile traits, as well as his commitment to GRC, congratulations, Isaiah Chisholm. Sorry, we're gonna get it together. We have one more medallion. Mr. Burnsworth, would you join me? Okay. We would like to recognize Mr. Joe Burnsworth. For the past 6 years, Mr. Burnsworth has worked above and beyond to ensure that Green Run Collegiate was recognized throughout the school community. Mr. Burnsworth could have stayed retired after 40 years with Virginia Beach City Public Schools, but it was to our benefit that he didn't. His dedication has been nothing short of extraordinary. Tirelessly, he networked with community leaders, he wrote grants, raised funds, and so much more. It's hard to describe everything he has done, and we owe him a great deal, as the school's success heavily relied on what he has done for our students. As his term comes to an end, we would like to bestow the Laureate Medallion and a commemorative plaque to him for his service both to the school and its board. On behalf of the Green Run Collegiate family, thank you.
Thank you. I am so pleased to introduce our commencement speaker, Mr. Mark Johnson. As the Senior Vice President and Community Development Manager at Truist Bank, Mr. Johnson is responsible for overseeing the community development activities in the state of Virginia for the company. An exemplary steward of community service and a champion of philanthropic efforts in the Hampton Roads community, he is constantly working to align the bank with charitable organizations and innovative that promote positive change within the community. Mark's continued efforts have been recognized through a number of awards, such as the Hampton Roads Inside Business Top 100 Power List, the Urban League of Hampton Roads Silver Star, and the UNCF 2022 Mast Award, to name a few. Mr. Johnson serves on a number of boards and committees, to include the Life Enrichment Center of Norfolk, WHRO, and the Green Run Collegiate Foundation Board. Now, without further ado, I present your speaker, Mr. Mark Johnson.
Thank you for that warm introduction. Listen, it is a tough act to follow, Luke, Mariah. You know, I was getting ready to call it in. You presented everything that I want to say, but I do have a couple of points I want to make. And Joe, I thank you so much. You were the one that convinced me to join the board. Going back to when my son, he was part of the first inaugural class, and so I know the rigor of the program, the expectations of the program, and as a parent, I am so proud of the work that you put in that brings you here today to kind of launch yourselves to be successful adults. So thank you for your service, Joe, and I appreciate you being a good friend and a professional. Thank you. Just a couple of quick notes. This is what I call my drive-through comments. I don't know if some of you probably see me at some of your jobs, whether it's through the drive-through at Taco Bell or Panera, what have you. But this is my comments that I always kind of engage young people in when I drive through, because I have a life of wanting to see the next generation, the next citizens, be better than us. We've seen so much in the last 5 to 10 years, and in your duration of 4 years, you can grab or you can develop as many skill sets as you want, but I think our goal is to teach you to be good people. And so these are a couple of notes that are near and dear to me in my 30 years as a professional that I just wanted to give you that kind of helped me through and develop as I was trying to find out what my purpose was and who I wanted to be in this great country, in this life. And so the first piece is Built to Last. It's a book that was written by Jim Collins and Jerry Porras, and it speaks to the successful habits of visionary companies. Results of a research project that explored what leaders need to endurably build great companies. What leaders then have to make success exceptional companies as well. You possess that same spirit, that same sense of resilience, critical thinking skills, and visionary skills that makes those organizations in you built to last and generationally successful. Number two, I'm always asking, what's next? You can never go forward looking into the rear view mirror. And those of you know that in terms of learning how to drive a car, you know, you look through the rear view mirror, it always says, you know, objects are closer than you think. But you can never drive a car going backwards. Reflection is a great asset. It allows you to put your life choices, good and bad, into perspective. But to grow, to expand, to have substantial impact, there must be a next. Let's call it your sequel. Everybody needs to have a sequel. Third, you need to have an attitude of gratitude. In life, there will be many challenges, pitfalls, letdowns, wins and losses. But learn to have an attitude of thanks and graciousness. No matter what you accomplish in life, learn to say thank you to all of those people who will be helpful to you to achieve incredible feats during your journey. Thank you to individuals who breathe when you don't know how to breathe for yourselves. Thank you to those who have the courage to bribe you with courage when you don't have courage yourself, and to those who have wisdom when you are still trying to develop your thoughts. You must understand that leaders eat last. In a book written by Simon Oliver Sinek that explores the ways in which successful individuals and companies develop cultures built on sacrifice and trust, it speaks to why we need great leadership and how we suffer without it. Leadership isn't just about meaningful numbers. It's about helping people to thrive and find their meaning in their work. Be transformational in your relationships. You may eat last, but you're going to eat. And lastly, this is one that is near and dear to my heart. Several years ago, I had a conversation with my mother. She was a single parent, of course, raising three children and just working one or two or three jobs just to make ends meet. And my mother has always told me how proud she was and how proud she is of me. She didn't have an opportunity because she couldn't afford to come visit me in college a lot. But my mother was a praying woman, as a mother, woman of faith. And we sat down after one of my award ceremonies and she said, "You know, I'm just so proud of you." She said, "But I got to be honest with you, I could have never given you what some of the people who came into your life and you were connected to gave you in terms of your growth." And I told my mother, I said, "You know, don't you ever say that." I said, "You gave me the one thing that has been my foundation and has been my rock and has really made me the person I am today. You gave me hope. In a world which is so challenging that sometimes it seems as if we're never going to get beyond division, we're never going to get beyond not really thinking on one accord, I think life provides us with opportunities to love one another and to understand our differences. But hope has allowed me to understand that even on the worst days is your best day. That grounded in hope is the opportunity that even when you're not invited to certain functions, and even when you have souring relationships, or even when you might not even work out on your job, hope would allow you to come back and say one of the greatest words that I think we take for granted: good morning. Learn how to say good morning to every person that you come in contact with, and learn how to say good morning to every situation and circumstance that you'll ever have. Because good morning means I get to begin again. My name is Mark Johnson. What is your name? What is your purpose? Finish strong. Thank you.
Johnson. Please accept this small gift as a token of our appreciation for your insights that you shared with us today.
Thank you. Appreciate you.
It's funny that Mr. Johnson talked about purpose, because I'm going to revisit that again with you all, just coming from a little bit of a different perspective. So y'all are graduating, and while graduating is often seen as a milestone, it's not free from doubt and from a sense of loss. After all, you have worked towards this one singular goal, and after many years, you have finally grasped that goal. It was once just a lofty, intangible dream. Now, after reaching it, some of you may wonder what is next. My hope is that whether it is attending college, joining the workforce, or enlisting in the military, you find a sense of purpose that drives you to do more. And so, what does that mean, a sense of purpose? And how do you know
when you've discovered it. You know, I think that happiness is probably the most common and most known trait when it comes to finding what moves you. For example, I find joy in the big and small achievements I earn as an educator. The pressure I feel when reaching them is exhilarating. It's like finishing like your first internal assessment or personal project. I get so pumped when I realize that despite a huge undertaking, I did that. I also find such humor when things go horribly wrong. Stress has a funny way of giving you insight on life's ironies and quirks that I find myself laughing in spite of what obstacles I face. I don't think this would occur if I didn't do something that I loved. So in the field of education, I've found something that makes me happy through the big, the small, the good, the bad, the ugly. So let's talk about discomfort. Discomfort is another valuable characteristic when it comes to purpose. Jet, you once said that no one grows when they are uncomfortable. So purpose requires challenge and change. It forces you to move to the next level. When I think of discomfort, I think of tennis great Rafa Nadal. Recently, he's decided that next year will be his last year of playing professional tennis, the great passion of his life. But that does not mean he's giving up on the sport. He'll transition to other roles within that field. He has found ways to adjust, to grow, and to evolve when he retires from playing competitively. This is where I come back to gratitude. Lastly, having purpose will always lead to gratitude. It will guide you on this unpredictable journey where you discover your identity. You will find yourself on adventures that fortify your bonds with others. You will test yourself and see that you are stronger than you think. That self-awareness will allow you to be thankful for every person who has made an impact on you, for every experience that has made you who you are, and for every opportunity that was given to you because of the kindness of others. So, class of 2023, we wish you well as you continue your travels without us. May you find a purpose that will fill you with happiness, that will push you through times of discomfort, and that will remind you of the meaning of gratitude. Best of luck in all your future endeavors. All right, 10 more minutes. Faculty and staff, let's please prepare for the distribution of diplomas.
Parents, families, and guests, we ask that you hold off on celebrating until after the graduation ceremony is concluded. Please remember that we want to equally recognize every GRC student who crosses the stage today. Nolawit Abibi, cum laude. Alfonso Adams. Kinari Empress Alagon, cum laude. Tatiana Princess Anderson, honors. Devin Wayne Bowden, honors. Elisa Bragg. Faith Michaela Brown, honors. Jet Carlo Bugarin, cum laude. Janaya Alicia Calhoun, honors. William Cannon. Landon Carlisle. Isaiah Chisholm. Alex Michael Sidlovich. Olivia Fancy Klinkscales. Christina Anastasia Council, honors. Alfred James Freyanilla David, honors. Dinesia L. Dozier. Zoe Franklin, honors. Ashlyn Estelle Freeman, honors. Brianna Lynn Gardner. Josiah Lynn Gardner. Jonathan George. Shane Joseph Goebel, honors. Jonathan Jovan Othno Gray, magna cum laude. Robert Gray, honors. Shayna Grames, cum laude. Tasneem Hyder, cum laude. Jasmine Marie Harding Henson, cum laude. Jemiah Shantae Harris, honors. Reagan O'Byrne Hebert, cum laude. Jaina Lynn Heimkrask, honors. Zoe Amber Hendershot, summa cum laude. Kyla Lachey Jackson, cum laude. Ellis Michael Johnson Jr. Neam Lego, cum laude. Kristen Maynor. Ahmad McDaniel, summa cum laude. Oh. Brianna Madison Mendiola, honors. Braden Messick, magna cum laude. Anaya Janae Michalak, honors. Raquel Ashanti Miller. Rihanna Moat, magna cum laude. Jeffrey Howard Newton, honors. Cameron Mark Nobles. Christopher Michael Nobles, Jr. Nadia Beatrice Norris. Quinn Patrick. Paige Madeline Richardson, cum laude. Heaven Gabrielle Roberts, cum laude. David Emmanuel Robles, honors. Michaela Retzel, honors. Dot Rora Looper, summa cum laude. Quincy Omari Sanchez. Brianna Dolores Sanders, honors. Elias Santiago, honors. Jemiah Lene Simpson, summa cum laude. Shania Janae Simpson, summa cum laude. Alexis Joan Taylor, summa cum laude. Adrian Paris Abante Valencia, honors. Taylor Lynn Wallenberg Cooksey, honors. Michaela Walter. Janiyah Faith Karma Watford, honors. Sydney Jade Weddle, cum laude. Jacob Wes Wyman, honors. Shawan Christopher Young, honors. Mariah Kennedy, magna cum laude. Luke Moore, summa cum laude.
Graduates, please stand. It is my privilege to certify that these candidates have fulfilled the requirements set forth by the Commonwealth of Virginia and the School Board of the City of Virginia Beach. It is with great pride that I present to you the graduating class of 2023. Graduates, you may switch your tassels. I now declare that you have graduated. This concludes our ceremony, but please remain seated until all staff and graduates have exited the ballroom. Then family and friends, please exit through the entry doors on the right. You may meet your graduates outside the building.